I love you, dude.
What's up, and welcome back to the channel. Dude, go clean up your trains, dude. Do you want to go to the sandbox, Lincoln? Do you want to go to the sandbox?
Yeah.
Okay, then you got to go clean up the rest of your trains, dude. We're not going to go anywhere before that happens. As soon as it's going to be time for bed. Dude, clean up your trains. Go clean up your trains, Lincoln. He literally has just to clean up those trains. There's just a little, there's like probably like 10 pieces left. And there's probably only like 50 pieces in total, but it's taking him an hour to clean it up. And I've been waiting. We're going to go on a workout. So we're going to take you guys with us to go hit the workout, see how little man does at the workout. We're going to go to the Legion, the track it's called. And there's also some sandboxes there that I like take him to. So he pretty much plays in the sandbox, enjoys the little kind of like track area. And I get a chance to crush the workout because I've had him for the most part full time and also like without a day home. And so I've had to make adjustments in how I do things throughout the day. And so one of those adjustments is like finding time to still work out because that's still a priority and still a value in my life is my physical health. And so it's just like, it just looks different. And that's the whole concept. It's a whole idea. That's the whole like movement. If you can always adapt to what your situation is and make it happen anyways, that's where you want to be. That's where I want to be. I want to be in those spaces because if I don't work out, if I don't get and take care of myself in those ways, then what am I teaching my son? Those are things that I always ask myself. Lincoln, no jumping, mister. You get to go clean up your trains. Otherwise, dad's going to go, mister. And you're not going to come to the sandbox with us.
I'm not.
Okay, you're not going to come. You don't have to clean up either. You don't have to do any of that stuff. You know, and we'll just stay here and hang out here and for the rest of the day, and then we'll go to bed. Oh, you're coming? Well, you have to go clean up the rest of your trains first. No jumping on dad. You have to clean up the rest of your trains, Lincoln.
Yeah.
Lincoln, go clean up the rest of your trains. He does, it's crazy. Like, I've been in a... I've been trying to make him take 100% responsibility for any toy he brings out, anything he does, he gets to clean up fully. I do not get to clean it up. And it's a hard thing to do because, like I said, I wanted to go work out an hour ago. And we've literally been here trying to clean up the remaining 10 pieces for an hour, and I'm not going to help him. And I've just been doing other things. So let's take you along for the ride. First, we got to get this man to clean up his toys. Once we do that, let's get going. It's going to be a big, hefty one today. And if anyone wants to know what workout program I'm doing, just leave that in the comments down below, and I'll link you to it. It's a free 6-week kettlebell program, which is dope as well. So, Lincoln, go clean up your stuff, okay? Dad's not going to ask again. I'm going to leave you in here until you clean them up.
I'm cleaning them by now.
Okay. Lincoln. Okay. Clean up your trains, Lincoln. Sometimes it's so hard trying to get your children to do what it is that you want them to do. And sometimes it's just exhausting because they just don't want to listen, or they're incredibly tired, or they want to sit in a window and blow at you. Jesus. All I want to do is go for a workout, you know? And it's like, it's me being okay with it taking this long as well and letting go of control and letting go of it having to look a certain way and be that certain way so that he learns the lesson. Like, it's all about consistency. If I was to break, especially with like they take advantage and they challenge integrity like nobody's business. Like nobody's business. It's one of the chapters in the upcoming chapters of Out of Control is like how kids just challenge my like integrity. And that's their responsibility, is to challenge your integrity. Do you stick to what you say you say? You know? Do I say, Lincoln, you're responsible for cleaning up all your toys? But then halfway through, do I alleviate the pain by helping them clean them up? Or do I let them actually do it? Do I
say that I'm not gonna help you get in the bathtub, but do I go and help him get in the bathtub, or do I go and do those things? Or do I say, I'm not gonna help you fill up your water bottle anymore, but then do I see him struggling, fill up his water bottle? Like, it's all of those things that I sit with, and I'm like, okay, consistency, consistency, consistency. How can I keep showing up in integrity with what I say that it is that I want, instead of just alleviating the pain? Because that's all that I'm doing. It's just like short term versus long term. It's all about the long term. I want him to be able to clean up his toys and to feel good cleaning up his toys, and to make it a game and make it fun and have that for him. It's still incredibly hard to get him to do those things. Like, it's not a cakewalk for me. It's not easy at all. It's like, it's probably now an hour and 30 minutes that I've been waiting to go work out. And it's just letting go and allowing myself to find joy, find presence, find stillness, even in these moments, like sitting here just outside, like enjoying the beautiful garden and space. It's incredible. It's incredible out here. So now I just get to sit out here and enjoy it before I work out, which is just as peaceful and just as nice. But we're going to try to get this wrapped up so we can get going, because I really do want to go do a workout. Not going to lie. And I want it to be sooner than later.
Yeah.
Are all your trains clean, dude? Are they clean? See, in states like these, he's just so tired. But he said that they're clean, so let's go take a look.
Dude, you did a lot better of a job, but there's still some trains left.
No! I still have...
You gonna clean them up? Okay, then go clean them up. Put them away, mister. We can put them in the bin.
What? You're all done?
Yeah.
Come here, double high fives. Good job, dude. You did it. It took you an hour and a half. You did it. High five. Yeah, dude.
Yeah.
Are you ready to go to the sandbox?
Yeah.
You want to go sandbox?
Yeah.
After an hour and a half, finally got it clean. So let's go crush the workout.
Put
all your teddy bears. Put them in. You take that one too?
Yeah.
And this one too. You got your teddies? All lined up. Ready to drop? Ready to hop in your seat, please? Ready to go?
Yeah, ready to go.
Wicked. So we just pulled up the track. Little man is sleeping still. But that doesn't matter. I'm feeling kind of lethargic, not gonna lie. It's about 4 o'clock, so we gotta get this workout in. Let's go. Homemade organic banana bread. Oh, the best snack post workout. Oh, that's so good. So good. I wanted to this month of August eat less grains. Like eat less bread. And I was actually gonna go the whole month without eating wheat. It's ironic because I went and bought a bunch of just bananas and they went bad. And there's like six bananas that are like going extremely ripe and just sitting in the fridge. And I'm like, what can I do with these? I was like, I could freeze them, but I don't want to do that because when I freeze bananas, to be honest, I never use them. I never eat them. I'll just throw them out. So it's a waste of time. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna make myself an agreement. This banana bread will be the last wheat that I have this entire month. So here we go. I'm gonna savor this last piece, man. This last piece of banana bread. Lincoln, do you want a piece of banana bread? Come have a bite, mister, okay? It's the last one. I'm gonna give him the first bite. Just because there's... I did put the only thing that's not organic. There's a little bit of those M&Ms from a trail mix that are in there. Take a bite, mister. There you go. You have the rest?
Yeah.
Thank you, dude. Cool. Oh. Cheers. No wheat in August. Let's do this. Just veg, man. Just veg. I love you, dude. I love you, dude. Did you pee on the ground right there? Did you pee right there? Nice work, dude. There you go, dude. You want to show some construction equipment, dude? Yeah. What do you got here? What's this stuff? What do you got here, dude? Where are all your toys? What is that?
It's a big kid, isn't it?
What is it, Lincoln?
It's a big ball.
It's a big ball?
Yeah, it's going on day and better.
What is this one? What is this one, dude?
Dump truck.
That's a dump truck?
Yeah.
Cool. What about this one? What's this one? What is it?
A backhoe.
That's a backhoe? What about this one, dude? What's this one?
Loader.
That's a loader. And what about this one, dude?
Excavator.
What's this one?
Big.
It's a big one.
It's a big one.
It's a big one, dude.
What? On that.
That's it for us, to be honest. We're gonna go eat some delicious garden fresh food, probably cook a little bit of a stir fry up. Thank you guys for coming along our journey. Hopefully you enjoyed today's video. I wish and hope the best and that you guys are all doing extremely well. And remember to subscribe to the channel. Also feel free to like and comment what was your favorite part from today's video. And from us to you, so much love. Right, Lincoln? I just want to give a quick shout out to all of these single parents and parents out there that are out there doing their best. Like, hats off to you. My respect, honor, everything off to you. It's a hard journey, and it's a hard journey to do it on your own if you are a single parent. And to be honest, there is a lot of parents and a lot of people in a relationship, in a marriage with kids that are still doing it alone. You know, like there is someone there, but they're still doing it alone. A lot of moms out there that are doing it alone, and I'm sure that there's some dads out there that are doing it alone too. So just so much respect to you guys and for doing the work that you do and for being you. Like, we're raising the next generation of beautiful human beings that are going to take over the world and rule the world and run the world. And that is no easy task for anyone to bear. So and I know that for myself because it's not easy for myself. And there's lots of struggles, there's lots of hardships, lots of all of that stuff. And it will always get better. It's gotten better for me, it'll get better for you, it'll even get better for me. It'll keep on getting better. That's the way that I believe that life works, is that it always keeps on getting better if you want that to be the case. If you want it to be the case. And when things don't seem better and things seem hard, that's because it's my other belief, I have lots of beliefs, it's my belief that if things are hard, it's because you're clearing and making space in your life for more good to come in your life. Whenever I go through a phase where I'm down, where I'm hard on myself, where I'm feeling heavy, energetic, where I'm sad, where I'm melancholy, or whatever the case might be, usually it comes with the week after the most joy, the most love, the most upbeat I've ever felt in my life. And that's just because the hard stuff is clearing out to create more space for the good stuff. So hats off to you. And thank you for being a part of our journey, my journey. And let's keep this ball rolling. Let's keep it going and keep being better human beings, because that's what we are. We're amazing as we are, in what we are, in love. Peace.